Hey, what's up? This is Chris from ElectroFame. So today's review is about the Snopow M8, which is like a rugged smartphone, so Android smartphone, of course. So this phone has a particularity, actually two particularities. The first one is actually his IP68, so which means like it's dust tight, so dust proof, and protection. So the 8 means actually protection against complete continuous submersion up to 1.5 meters in the water for 30 minutes at least. So it's pretty cool. And the second particularity of this smartphone is actually it has a PTT, so the talkie-walkie, up to 3 to 5 kilometers in the 400-800 megahertz. So we'll get through everything just for a quick introduction. So this phone come in a little suitcase, kind of, it's in a plastic one, so we can open it and see what's going on in the package. It's pretty complete. So we have here actually one USB charger, then we have one USB cable, so micro USB, USB, then we have earphones with a 3.5 mm jack, then we have kind of a key holder or something to hold with a compass on it, okay. Then we have actually a little screwdriver, mini screwdriver. I will show you why in a very, very short while. And we have one antenna, this one, so flexible. Then you can put on the back of the phone, which will increase actually the signal. So we will check it very shortly. And here is a 3000 mAh battery, so which will last a long time. So then, it's not finished yet, so here we have the smartphone itself, but and that, we still have two more items. So here we have, actually for once, a very interesting user guide, which explains to you in English everything. So the some warnings, but this is like the safety and performances, but this is not the most important. The most important for you is actually here. It explains how to use the talkie-walkie and in detail, so with all the frequencies and everything. So it's actually pretty interesting for once. And here we have the last but not least, a screen protector, screen guard. So here this is anti-glare, anti-UV, no added bulk, invisible protection, scratch-proof, reusable and bubble-free. So that's actually a nice package inside of the box. And now let's have a look actually. So yeah, the last thing I just want to say with all the items, actually you can carry it wherever you want, so it's like a little suitcase kind of. Huh? So, and then, what else? This is the Snopow M8, it's a rugged smartphone, I repeat. It's very tough, you can go for it before destroying it, that's for sure. So we see here, this is IP68, so certified. So what is going on with this smartphone here? Quickly, we have actually like a 4.5 inch screen, resolution of 960 by 540. We have two cameras on it. So we have here a 2 megapixels camera, but actually it's extra interpolated to 5 megapixels. And here on the back, we have an 8 megapixels camera. Otherwise, we have the flash, which is very intense. We'll check it out later. Except that, not much for the basics. The most interesting stuff is actually on the side, so it's all about soft plastic, so it holds very well in hands. It's not that heavy, it's like 292 grams with the battery inside, so it's not that much, to be honest, for a rugged phone. So otherwise on the side here we see that we have a lot of buttons. So this one here is actually for the PTT, for the talkie-walkie, so you have to hold it when you want to talk with people. Here we have the SOS button, then we have for the flashlights, if you want to turn it on and turn it off. We have the volume buttons here. On the other side, we have here, protected again, everything is protected on this one. We have the 3.5 mm jack and the USB slot here. Then we have the power button, and here we have the reset button if you need it, and on the bottom here we have actually the camera button, so quick access to camera. So if you press it first just one time, you know, it will launch the camera, and if you press it again, it will take a picture, and if you keep going on it, it will actually take like a burst shot. So it will take like 30, 40 pictures in a very, very short time. So here, otherwise, we have the microphone. So you see here we have like a few different buttons. So the menu, home, back, and search button. So it's a pretty complete phone, to be honest, and it's very nice. So the last thing here is actually the, if I can take it off. For the antenna. Okay, here we go. So here, this is what I told you before. So you just put the antenna on it, and this will increase actually your signal. So most of the time, the people will use it for the PTT, so the talkie-walkie. It might increase a bit the Wi-Fi and your 3G signal, but won't be that much. You know, it's most of the time only for PTT. I was talking about the screwdriver before. So here we go. This is actually to help you, so you can unscrew everything. And so this is really to show you that this smartphone is extremely protected and you will have no problem at all. So you can go up to 1.5 meters in the water, as I told you. So you can keep this screwdriver or you can use another one, it's up to you. What is more convenient, we try to use what is inside of the box just to show you what is going on, basically. So you have 6 screws on the back, and this will help protect your phone perfectly. And then we will be able to see actually what is inside exactly. Alright, so we can just take it off. So here we go. That's it, it's inside. So we have 2 SIM cards. So one is 3G, one is GSM, as most Chinese phones do. And we have here a SD card up to 32 gigabytes, which is very useful because this phone is actually 1 gigabyte of RAM and 4 gigabytes of internal memory, so it will be very useful, and then you can just take it off and put it wherever you want in the computer or whatsoever to save some data and play some music or what. So the last thing I didn't say here is actually the speaker. So it looks like, you know, it has a hole inside, so you don't maybe believe that actually you can put it in the water, but however, it doesn't matter, you know, we will try it at the end of this video, you know, I will show you that it already holds, you know, in the water, but basically the water will go inside, and it doesn't matter at all, because when you will take it off, the speaker will just take a bit of time to recover, but it will not harm actually the smartphone itself. So basically that's it for the smartphone, for the shape and appearance. The only thing we can say is about the dimensions, just to give you an idea about what is going on. So we have here a smartphone of length which is like 150.6 millimeters by 76.8 millimeters, and its thickness, okay, it's quite thick, but it's like 21.9 millimeters. This is what you need actually to have a rugged smartphone, like really tough and powerful. So this would fit perfectly people who are working in tough environments like farms or different construction sites. So it's a perfect smartphone and you will not be scared of breaking down. So basically now let's put the battery on and let's get started in order to see what's going on inside of the smartphone. All right, so we can get started now. So here we go, this is the boot screen. So here we go, pretty fast to start, to be honest. So we can have a look. So this is, we have here actually a quad core processor clocked at 1.2 gigahertz, 1 gigabyte of RAM and 4 gigabytes of internal memory up to 32 gigabytes. So that's for quick specifications. So let's have a look at the toggles, for example. So this is basic Android 4.2.1. For the toggles, what we have inside, so we have actually the battery, airplane mode, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, GPS, data connection, data usage. You can check your audio profile, so it's like a normal, basically, smartphone for sure. So the brightness is set up to the maximum for this review. And then the timeout you can make and the auto rotation on and off. So that's it basically. Now let's have a look at the settings, which is one of the most important things, to be honest. So SIM management, because you have two SIM cards inside, and I repeat, one is 3G, WCDMA, and the other one is GSM only. So we have the Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, data usage more, then we have the airplane mode, VPN. Here you can see the NFC. Actually, the NFC is an option. So here it looks like you can enable it, but this model doesn't have the NFC. We have been checking it out. So we will try to to get maybe the next model, which would have the NFC, but we cannot promise it so far. So we can just go back now. Audio profiles, display, and storage. Storage, so we can check it out. So we have here, we see all total 4 gigabytes, so 1.52 plus 600 megabytes available on it. So it's like 2.2 gigabytes available when you get the phone, which is not that bad. So we still invite you to install the SD card for sure. So the battery, which is like a 3000 mAh battery, which will last at least a day. You know, we have made some tests in here, and it was lasting for a long, long time. Of course, it always depends on what you use at the same time. If you use all applications plus the PTT plus everything, of course, it might not last a whole full day, but it should still last a long time. So location access for the GPS, security, language and input. So what kind of languages do we have inside? So here you can check it out. The list is pretty long anyway. We still have a lot of languages, so you might find yours inside. So then we go back. So Google account, because you have the Google Play Store on it, so you can have access to all your favorite applications and download them through the Play Store, no problem at all. Date, time, schedule, power on, off, accessibility, developer options. What is going on there? We have actually like a lot of options. So for the advanced users of Android, they will be able to modify a few stuff. Then about the phone here, we can check it. This is like the M8 and Android 4.22 on it. We can even check if you want Android Jelly Bean 4.22. Okay, so let's go back now and let's keep going a bit more inside of the specifications. So for that, we launch Antutu benchmark. For the people who don't really know what is Antutu or what is a benchmark, it just allows you to test the performances of your device and to get a score out of it most of the time. So here we have a score of 14,229, which is not that bad if we actually regarding of the specifications, basically. So let's have a look at what is going on inside of the phone. Oh, sorry. So we have here the M8, Android 4.22 on it, the MT6589 quad-core processor clocked at 1.2 GHz on it. We have the graphic processor PowerVR SGX544MP, which is not that bad, to be honest. 960 by 540 for the resolution. So we have an IPS screen on it. 8 megapixels on the back for the camera. Here we say we have no root access, but we'll check it later just to confirm it or not. So we have 1 gigabyte of RAM and 4 gigabytes of internal memory, 2.1 available right now. We have quad-core processor, as I say, 1.2 gigahertz, 240 dpi for the density, which is actually not that bad either. Multi-touch, we'll try it later on to see what's going on. Here we say 5 megapixels for the front-facing camera. Actually, it's a 2 megapixels interpolated to 5 megapixels. Then for the rest, so here say NFC support, but actually it doesn't really support NFC, so please bear that in mind. Wi-Fi, and then for the sensors we have quite a bunch. So direction sensor, acceleration sensor, light sensor, e-compass, proximity and gyro sensor. This is all what you get inside of this phone. So now let's have a look at the different other apps. So First of all, let's try the root access. So this, your device doesn't have root. So basically, if you want to change the Android version, you will first have to root your device. So if you really fancy doing that, we can advise you going to the XDA forum, for example. We have checked already and you have some tutorials on how to root it and how to change the Android version. So otherwise, what else? Actually, what we want to check is actually the multi-touch. So here, if we drop it on the table and we put everything we have here, we can see this is a 5-touch capacitive screen. Then, before talking about other things, actually what we can just try is the GPS. So for that, we just launch it and we just check it out. So the GPS is on, we already have 12 in view. However, we are here in the house. So I just went outside and here we can see we still have the results. So this is like, we were at 16 feet accuracy. So inside of the house, it's not that performant, but outside was no problem. After 30 seconds, it was stabilized and we had like 15, 16 meters accuracy, which is pretty nice. So just please bear in mind that inside of the house is not that good. So that's it basically for the everything. So now we can just check actually the sound and the video. So for that we have like a little video to show you. We can just check it out. We can turn up the sound. So we see that auto rotation is working perfectly, no problem at all. So the sound is actually extremely powerful. We have never seen that before on a smartphone. It's actually very, very, very powerful. So when you're outside, you will have no problem. You hear everybody on the PTT, so the talkie-walkie and whatsoever. And this is the screen is actually pretty nice. Can watch Maui's videos on it without any trouble at all. That was actually the big surprise of this smartphone, that the speaker is actually extremely powerful. So that was to show you. Now, one of the latest points I want to talk about, is actually the talkie-walkie. I'm talking about that since the beginning and what it is exactly. So here we go. We launched the application and this is where we are. So it looks a bit maybe complicated just like that, but here you can see that you can actually create the new channels. So basically what is going on, you can actually set up the frequency you want to use with your partner. So if he has the same smartphone or another talkie-walkie, for example. So please bear in mind that actually the 400 to 800 megahertz will have a range to 3 to 5 kilometers with this application. So if we go back, so you can set up different things. So here they say actually what is going on. So the walkie-talkie flexible, majority of countries in the world, Intercom standards without authorization is strictly prohibited to commercial, of course. So this is what is going on. So you can set up a lot of different things. It's no problem at all. So you can set up your own frequencies. And that's it. So the user guide, the user manual is actually explaining that very, very well. So here you see, this is like kind of the welcome page of the application. So I told you before here, this button is actually when you press on it, you will be allowed to speak on it. It's like to make sense basically. So it's pretty useful. It's a good application. So it allows you actually to not use any data and just have this talkie-walkie feature. So otherwise, before I was saying that here, for example, you have the SOS. So when you click on it, you see it just launched the emergency number. So basically, you can set up which number you want. So depending, you know, if you're living in America or if you're living in Europe or if you're living in Asia, no problem at all. You can always set up in the settings your number, your emergency number of your country. So it's no problem at all. Then the button here on the side, I was saying this was for the camera. So let's check it out. So we launch it. So you see, it's launching the camera itself, and then if you press on it, take one picture, if you press longer, burst shoots. So you can just stop, and that's it, 40 pictures right away in a short time. So it's pretty useful, and you see that everything is working fine. So of course, this smartphone will be for people who are working or living in tough environments or just don't care so much about the smartphone and want something very, very tough. So I repeat, this is IP68, so IP for ingress protection, and 6 for actually dust tight, so it's dust proof, so contact proof. You will have no problem. You can even like run with Jeep over it, you know, with steel work for sure, no problem. So the 8 is actually for the protection against complete continuous submersion. So it is certified up to 1.5 meters for up to 30 minutes for sure, and it's shockproof, so you can just throw it, you know, from 2 meters without any problem at all. After 2 meters, maybe something will happen, but still 2 meters, you know, it will hold very well. So we have a 3000 mAh battery inside, which lasts like at least for a day for sure. We have 2 megapixels on the front facing camera, interpolated to 5 megapixels, 8 megapixels on the back. The flashlight here that you can launch with actually this button here on the sides. You see? So it's working very well, and it's actually very bright. Otherwise, we have a 4.5 inch screen, resolution of 960 by 540, 1 GB of RAM, 4 GB of RAM, up to 32 GB by SD card, quad core processor 6589 clocked at 1.2 GHz, and average weight of around about 300 grams in your hands. So this is what you get with a Snopow M8. So now, as I told you at the beginning of this video, that we will actually test proof this ability to be waterproof or not. So of course, we are here on the inside of the house, so we don't have any pond or any seaside, but we have here a bottle of water, which is not that bad. So we can actually just check it out, and we can even launch a movie. So we can just come back to the movie where we were before and just launch it, and we just drop it inside. So we can still hear the sound actually, which is pretty fun. So you see, you can even watch actually a movie inside of the water, and you can still actually hear it, you know? So you see, it's working perfectly, it's no problem. So here we go. No, sorry. So it's still working very well. So it's a very, very good smartphone for people. And it's working perfectly, as you can see. So basically, this is it for the review of the Snopow M8. So if you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment below the video, and we will get back to you as soon as possible. Otherwise, if you want to purchase or get more specifications about this smartphone, please click on the top left corner of this video, and it will redirect you on our website, or just go directly to www.electrofame.com. And otherwise, until then, I hope you enjoy it, and see you later for the next one then. Bye bye!